But I have two more quick ones. Is that cool? You guys want to hear two more?
Yeah. Means I'm doing a good job.
Yeah. Okay. So this one's kind of, that my punk rock days. This is kind of punk rock for what I do, I guess. So you guys feel more comfortable? See this? American pride right here. You have no idea how many Budweiser's that is. Anyway, yeah, feel free to come down and hang out if you want to. For now, it's called the dance song.
Thank you.
Thank you guys for having me. Thank you, Sam. Thank you. Beautiful. Hope you enjoyed. Hell of shit coming up. Stay tuned.
Actually very excited to play in Amsterdam. I never played here before. I came to Holland, but it was six years ago. So it was a long time ago. And I think now, this trip, I have a better understanding of, well, I mean, Amsterdam probably is not very typical Dutch because there's so many tourists around, you know, like me. But I think I have maybe a slightly better handle on the culture. So hopefully, I won't be as confusing to people as I have been in the past. I just had some, and you know, I probably shouldn't bring it up, but I just had some, these like weird experiences, you know. And so one of the shows that I did in Holland previously, after the show, somebody told me, oh, well, there's this real tradition in Holland of this kind of, maybe I'm misquoting the person, but I think he said it was sort of like musical comedy or something. So you would like play songs and then tell jokes or something and then kind of mix it up. And I don't know if he thought that was what I was trying to do. but because that wasn't really my intention at the time. But so I thought, okay, well, that's cool. And actually when at the symposium yesterday, I saw some slides of some of Michel Weschwitz's early performances, like especially the one where he was wearing those crazy big pants, you know, where the legs were like a foot wide. And they're covering his shoes, and then there's someone in a leotard doing a handstand on the piano behind him, you know. And I was like, oh, okay, that I can kind of understand. It's like some kind of, you know, Dadaist cabaret or something. but then I had this other experience. I forget. It was this gallery called the Local Belen. I forget where it was. And the curator was really disappointed, and after my set, he said, I thought it was going to be crazy electronics, you know, and it's a big gesture. And then he said, but it was singer-songwriter. I said, well, you know, I don't know, I had some songs. Like, I was just trying to play some songs. I won't be playing any songs tonight. So tonight, it will be more probably what he wanted to see back then. So unfortunately, I don't think he's here. That's just how life goes, you know, sometimes. Okay, thanks. Okay, the reason I have to talk before I play is I get very nervous. It's better to be up front about it. So I'm sorry. Okay, you know, it's funny because there's different things you get nervous about. And I was just talking with Taku before everyone came back in, and I said, you know, there's certain things that I don't get nervous about, like job interviews, no stress at all. It's like totally fine, you know, I can just go in and talk to them, because honestly, with these jobs, I don't care if I get them or not. And so, but when you have that attitude, it helps out, because they're like, oh, this person might be, you know, maybe we really need them here, because like, I just, I play it cool or whatever. worry about it, you know. And like going on dates, a lot of people get stressed out about, and that's a little bit, I get nervous, you know. And usually with public speaking, like right now actually I don't feel nervous. If as long as I just keep talking, I'll be fine. And which I know will bore everyone, so I won't do it forever. But so, you know, when I had to do presentations at school, you know, I had no problem. And, you know, if I was in a group, if there was a group project, I would always be the one to present it because it's, you know, easy and I just show the slides and talk about some stuff. But a year ago, I did my first scientific presentation at a physics conference. And I, you know, and I knew the material cold. I mean, I knew every equation on my slides just from memory and I could explain everything. You know, I definitely knew what I was doing. But I went up and I showed my slide and I took the laser pointer, this green laser pointer, and my hand is going like this. Amazing. And the point, you know, is moving like up and down the foot. And I'm just sort of like, okay, I'm in the vicinity of this switch. And I was so, I didn't understand it because it was a physical thing that happened, you know, and it mentally I didn't even really feel very nervous. I mean, I really knew what I was going to do, but, and then I started to smell, you know, it was really embarrassing, and I just thought, God, what do I do? So the next time, if that happens, I'll just make a joke, and I'll say, oh, I guess I must have drank too much coffee this morning, you know, and just play it off, because that way at least I can, you know. But that was an unexpected experience.
Thank you. that.
Och tror jag ägnande eller vad förutom mig själv som förbinder mig med världen.
Mon héritage est l'énigme qui me fait ressentir que jamais je ne saurais qui je suis, pourquoi je suis, ni ce qui pourrait me relier au monde en dehors de mon
Mein Erbe ist das Rätsel, das ich niemals wissen werde, wer was ich mit der Welt außerhalb meiner selbst verbinden könnte.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.